Hey y'all, I'm James Wright, and welcome to my shop. Today we're going to be talking about the ring trick. Now, if you've watched my channel for any amount of time, you know that I put a ring on my bit every single time, and I've got a whole video dedicated to why that is. I'm going to show you a little bit, but I actually did a bunch of testing about different rings and trying to find what is the best one for the ring trick. Today, let's take a look at that. So the way the ring trick happens is it tells you if you are up or down. Now, a lot of people think that it just slides along the shaft, but that's not true because you actually have to lift it up a good ways in order for it to slide. If I'm up a little bit like this, it's not going to slide. But if I'm up a little bit and I start winding, then it moves. And it's actually allowing it to roll on the shaft is what makes it work. And so as I go, this will then tell me, do I need to go up or do I need to go down? And so I can move down or I can move up, and you can actually see the little bit of movement here and there will guide me to where I want to be on the shaft. So normally, I use my gold band, and I know that really freaks out a lot of people, but it works really well, and I found it to be incredibly accurate, and it tells me exactly what I want. And I thought, you know, there's got to be a cheaper solution, and I tried using PEX rings, I tried using collars that I sell with my burnisher kits, I tried washers, rings. Some people said use this so that it hangs and it slides better. And I've tried a whole bunch of other things that aren't listed here, but these are the most common ones that I came across. And I want to talk through what I found, because I went through and tested them all, different diameters, different thicknesses, different inside curvatures, different parameters, different weights. And there's a lot of things that affect it. So my first thought was these PEX rings. And the nice thing about that is they're dirt cheap. You can buy a whole bag of them for whatever. The cross section of this, if I were to split it, is just a flat rectangle. And so I have this flat rectangle that's riding on the shaft. So the problem with having that flat cross section is when it twists to ride up or down the shaft, it actually has to rise up a little bit as it has to meet that circumference. And so it tends to not do that. It will ride in one spot without moving up and down the shaft. So it doesn't give you very accurate information. You actually have to have a very large movement one way or the other in order to get this to roll up and down the shaft. The next up, I was looking at the key ring. That doesn't have that wide cross section, so it can pivot much easier. The problem is, it's got this joint here, and every time it hit that joint, it would kind of bounce, and that would cause me issues. Also, it's a bit narrow, so when it's on here, it twists very easily, and I tend to get erroneous measurements as it kind of wanders around on the shaft. So then we found these, and these have a cross section that's perfectly circular, and some of them are a little bit larger. And I thought this would be exactly what I want. So I ordered a bunch of them in four different sizes, thinking this would work perfectly. But then when I went to try it on there, these also rotated way too easily because there's just one point of contact. So if this is riding on top of the shaft, it's just touching at this one point. And that one point is not enough. It just allows it to twist easily on there. And so I found these to give a lot of erroneous measurements on there. I was kind of wondering why in the world was it that my ring worked when these didn't. The thing with my ring is that my ring doesn't have a flat cross section. It's ever so slightly curved and then rounded more on top. And so you kind of have this ovoid shape. And this slightly curved location will give you one point of contact, but it's a little bit larger. On top of that, it can rotate just a little bit without having to lift up like the PEX rings. And so this actually worked really, really well. But, you know, I'm not going to be able to sell lots of gold rings for this, and people don't want to go out and get married just so they can use it. So then I tried other things. I tried washers, and then I came across these, and there's a guy that I found who would make me specialty rings, and these are out of stainless steel, so they're a lot more durable than my gold. And these have that slightly rounded cross section. So then I got to playing with, is there a best thickness to them? And so I ordered them in all different sizes and shapes. So the best thickness this way is best the ring on there, trying to find the right diameter that actually works the best with the shaft. So what I found is this ultra wide, it's an 8 millimeter wide band by a size 7, was just about perfect for the average old shaft. And it was really, really close to about perfect for this. If I want to use it on these, I'd probably bump up to a size 9. But somewhere right around that is exactly what I want. And so this comfort fit ring that fits on the shaft is exactly what I want. It gives me a little bit of movement without overly erroneous movement up and down. It just gives me what I need to give me an accurate moment so I know I'm drilling perfectly level. So with these rings, sometimes I'll lower it down and it'll slide up, but sometimes I'm lower down here and it will then run up the shaft. And so this doesn't give me a very accurate reading because it can turn very, very easily. With the PEX rings on the flat shaft, they just don't move. I see I'm way down here and that's not moving anywhere it needs to be. And so that's not giving me any information at all because it's flat. The large washers I found to be about right. They were a little bit more erroneous, but not as much. Though they aren't as good, as you can see, I'm way down and it's working its way up the shaft. It can still pivot a bit too much. And so that's why I love this 8mm band. I can put it on here and it can move a little bit, but it doesn't move that much. As I come down, it automatically goes down the shaft. As I go up, it's coming back down the shaft. And so you can see it's giving me a very accurate, very quick representation of where I need to go. And then I can keep it right in the middle and balance. Oop, down a little bit, up a little bit. And it gives me a very quick response to what I want, so I know I'm drilling perfectly straight. So I know this is a bit over the top with one little dumb trick, but it's one of those tricks that I use all the time, and it was really bugging me why my ring worked so well, and all of these other things that I tried, washers and other rings, just didn't give me the information I wanted as accurately as my ring did. And so I was very, very happy to find these. And if you want, I can give you the link to the guy where he sells these, but you have to buy them in large packs. Or you can buy them on my website. So yes, if you do want to help out the channel, I'm selling these for $5.99 a piece. Just a tiny little ring, but it really does help out. And so if you like this and you'd like to help out the channel, there's a link to that down below. Otherwise, if you want to go buy it yourself, that's exactly what you're looking for. A comfort band, 8mm wide, about a size 7 to a size 9. That is the most accurate ring I've found that gives you a very good reading for what you have level. Now, if you want to see more about this and some other tricks you can do with it, I have a whole other video where I go into detail on the ring trick. And had a lot of fun with that. And I'd love to hear your thoughts and ideas. What have you tried? Have you tried something that I didn't think through? A lot of people absolutely swear by these, being able to hang it on there and the gravity moves it, but I found that not to work. I found it has to roll on a shaft to give you the most accurate reading. So I'd love to hear what you try. And let me know that in the comments down below. If you do have other thoughts, comments, you know where to put it. So thank you to everyone who's watching, and a big thank you to all the patrons on Patreon scrolling over on the side. And also I want to say thank you to all of the members here on YouTube, people who've clicked that join button. Without you guys, this channel wouldn't exist. So you can support through that way, or if you want to go buy a ring, they're in my website now. So I think that'll about do it now. And until next time, have a wonderful day. So if you like it, put a ring on it. There's a reason some people think I'm Sonic the Hedgehog.